Friends, today we'll be looking at the Sperner's theorem. So, first of all, we try to understand what a Sperner's family is. So, it is a family of sets, that is a collection of some sets. Let's say we take an example of three sets. So, these are the three sets which constitute a family. So, it must not include any two sets, X and Y, for which X is a subset of Y. That is, all the elements of X are contained in Y. So, in this, if we consider any two subsets, let's say we consider X as this and Y as this, then this is not a subset of this. This is not a subset of this. This is not a subset of this. And any combination of X and Y you can take. So, any pair, if we take, X is not a subset of Y. So, this is a Sperner family. This is a valid Sperner's family, but this is not a Sperner family, because if we take X as this, X is equal to this and Y is equal to this, then X is clearly a subset of Y. All the 1, 2, 3 are contained in Y. So that's why this is not a Sperner's family. Now we consider an example. The family of K element subset of an N element set is a Sperner family. So this is an n element set where n is equal to 5. It is having 5 elements in total. And we take the value of k as 3. So we take all the 3 element subsets of this n element set. So 1, 4, 5 is one of them, 1, 4, 9 is another, and so on. All the possible ways in which we can choose 3 out of 5 elements. Okay. So which will be 5C3 in this case. Now we are giving logic. Why is this kind of family a Sperner family? Because all of them have equal size, point number one, and no one can have exactly the same elements as the other one. So, because no family can contain any of the others, because a containing set has to be strictly bigger than the set if it is having at least one different element. So it can't have 1, 4, 5 as its element, because 1, 4, 5 we have already covered. Now if we want to have, this is X, I will make things more verbal, and this is Y, then X is a subset of Y only if I add this 5. But then the size of my subset will become 4, which is also not valid, because we are considering only subsets of size 3. So hence we have proved that the family of k element subset of n element set is a Sperner family. Now how many sets will be in the family? The number of ways in which we can choose 3 elements out of 5. So that is 5C3. So if we consider k as 2, it will be 5C2. If we consider k as 1, it will be 5C1. That is only 5 subsets. So to make NCR maximum for a given n, we should have the value of r as n by 2. So the graph will increase as we increase R for NCR, and then up till a point till that is n by 2, and then it will again decrease if we increase R more than n by 2. So this is the point where maximum is reached, and basically NC n by 2 is the maximum value of the size of the Sperner family. So what is Sperner's theorem now? Sperner's theorem states that what example we considered just above, it is actually the largest possible Sperner family over an n element set. So if we consider an n element set, we can't have a Sperner family of subsets having a size more than this. So any kind of subset we can't form. So this is the maximum size we can reach. or a Sperner family. So the in terms of notations, mathematically we can say S mod is less than or equal to NC n by 2. So this is the Sperner's theorem. Hope you understood what the statement of Sperner's theorem is, what a Sperner family is, and how all the k element subsets of a particular set form a Sperner family. Thank you, friends. Please like, share, and subscribe to the video.